let's hear the latest stories making headlines in the Filipino community.
Shocking news out of New York, where two Filipinos were assaulted and robbed in two different locations just a day apart. We begin with this Midtown Manhattan McDonald's, where no one bothered to help 53-year-old Melvin Dizon, who was beaten unconscious and robbed while he was getting breakfast on Monday. Customers and employees inside the fast food chain just stood there and watched as Dizon called out for help, for somebody to call the police, but no one did. A security video provided by the New York Police Department to ABS-CBN News showed Dizon's attacker coming up from behind, hitting him twice before flinging him against a wall and knocking him down with a hard punch. The attacker kicked Dizon before taking his wallet and cell phone, then fled the scene. Dizon sustained a severe head injury and is currently admitted at the Bellevue Hospital in critical but stable condition. Meanwhile, earlier on Sunday, a 73-year-old Filipino man was just buying some lottery tickets at a Midtown Manhattan store near Times Square when a man tried to grab his wallet. He resisted and kept his wallet, but after crossing the street to get away from the scene, the attacker followed him and pushed the elderly Pinoy to the ground on 8th Avenue and 40th. While it is not being investigated as a hate crime, reports say the victim believes he heard some racial slurs. The unnamed Filipino victim suffered pain, swelling, and abrasion around his left eye. He was transported to a nearby Bellevue Hospital and was in stable condition. Philippine Consul General El Mercato says this brings to 33 the number of anti-Asian hate and criminal incidents involving Filipinos that have been reported to or monitored by the consulate since last year.
They're afraid to take the subway, they're afraid to go out of their homes at night. There are more cases, but most of these are unreported.
And finally, in entertainment news, a popping phenomenal show with a teenage revelation. The musically talented family of Ding Dong Avanzado, Jessa Zaragoza, and their daughter Jada staged the San Francisco Bay Area leg of their Revelation U.S. tour, giving Capamilia a good time.
It was awesome. Oh my God, it was so worth it. We love it.
The TSC show at the Fox Theater in Redwood City was a homecoming for the Avanzados, and they made sure the fans knew how happy they were to be back in the Bay Area, where they lived for a while.
I'm just so excited, so pumped up, because we are finally back in the Bay Area. We are finally home!
And those were the latest headlines from North America. You can catch our stories online at news.abs-cbn.com/TFC News and on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel. Back to you guys for the rundown.